senators hit Health Secretary Francisco Duque III for claiming that there's no evidence that asymptomatic carriers of COVID-19 are contagious. Senator Nancy Binay says Duque is spreading false information.
Sobrang nakakabahan, Mr. President, po ang Secretary of Health na mismo ang nagsasabi ng maling info tungkol sa COVID-19.
Binay cites a situation report from the World Health Organization, saying the WHO didn't say that asymptomatic cases are not contagious. Meanwhile, Senator Migs Zubiri says he is very alarmed over Duque's statement that the Philippines is now in its second wave of COVID-19 infections, going into third.
I think we're the only country in the world that has admitted that we are on the second wave.
Several government officials also contradict Duque's statement. Executive Secretary Salvador Medialdea says he does not know what Duque is talking about. COVID-19 Task Force Chief Implementer, Secretary Carlito Galvez Jr., says the Philippines is trying to prevent a COVID-19 second wave. Malacanang insists that the country is just in the first wave. But in the House Health Committee hearing on Thursday, May 21, the Health Secretary backpedals on his statement.
There was a first wave, but very small, which consists of just three imported cases in January. Then we had nothing for February, and then this was followed by a bigger wave. So either way, it can be easily construed that where we are today is really the first major wave of sustained transmission.
As of Thursday, May 21, there are 13,434 confirmed cases, 846 deaths, and 3,000 recoveries. The Department of Social Welfare and Development asks for understanding from the public over delays in the decision-making that stalled the release of the second tranche of the Emergency Subsidy Program. In a briefing Thursday, May 21, the DSWD says 17.4 million beneficiaries out of the targeted 18 million have received their cash aid. The ESP is meant to run for 2 months, April and May. On April 24, Malacanang says only poor families under areas with enhanced community quarantine, or ECQ, would receive aid for the second month. President Rodrigo Duterte earlier said he wanted 23 million families to be included in the first and second tranche. Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello says his department estimates around 4 to 5 million Filipinos will be unemployed due to the coronavirus pandemic. At a Senate hearing, Senator Ralph Recto asks Bello about the estimate of some congressmen that the number could be as high as 10 million. Bello says it's possible because at least 2.6 million people have already temporarily lost their jobs due to closures and flexible working arrangements. Bello adds, the services sector, which accounts for 24 million of those employed in the Philippines, remains the hardest hit sector. The Labor Department seeks to implement a 25 billion peso recovery plan. U.S. President Donald Trump lashes out again at China over the coronavirus pandemic, blaming Beijing for mass worldwide killing. In his tweet, he refers to an unidentified wacko in China, saying, "It was the incompetence of China and nothing else that did this mass worldwide killing." Trump initially played down the seriousness of the threat and repeatedly said China was addressing the outbreak, but later blamed China for the international spread. Trump also threatened to cut U.S. funding to the World Health Organization for allegedly assisting China to cover up the extent of the outbreak. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Wednesday says the COVID-19 crisis ended U.S. illusions of close ties with China, saying, "We greatly underestimated the degree to which Beijing is ideologically and politically hostile to free nations." Pompeo adds, "China is led by a brutal, authoritarian regime." China's foreign ministry spokesman Zhao Lijian pushes back, calling out the many mistakes and loopholes on the U.S. side, their lies and rumors. actress Angel Locsin laughs off a $200 million bounty on her head. In an Instagram post, Locsin shares screenshots of a tweet offering $200 million to any supporters of President Rodrigo Duterte and GMA Network who can kill Kim Chu, Coco Martin, and Angel Locsin. The three celebrities recently spoke up against the government's move to shut down ABS-CBN. Locsin has been a vocal critic of the current administration. In another screenshot, Locsin posts a graphic with a quote alleging her to be a supporter of the New People's Army. Locsin also tags the National Bureau of Investigation, or NBI. Earlier, the NBI arrested public school teacher Ronel Mas, who said on Twitter that he would give a 50 million peso reward to anyone who would kill the president. The NBI has been busy summoning people who, in their view, may be liable for cyber libel during the coronavirus crisis.